Hi, hello. I'm Hassan. I'm going to speak with you today about hot teaching spots. And let me ask you first before we start, when you see the word spots, what's the first thing that comes to your mind? Yeah, you may think of circles, you may think of batches of colors. What about circles? When you see circles or when you hear the word circles, what's the first thing that comes to your mind? Things that come together. Collaboration, cooperation. So what if the circles collect together or come together, they would have lots of cooperation and collaboration. So that's what we are going to speak about today, hot teaching spots. How can we as teachers help each other in gaining professional development? And let me start first with the most important question. What is professional development? Let me give you choices. Do you think is it reading the latest teaching magazines? Is it the assessment and evaluation of students' progress? Is it the acquisition of skills and knowledge? Is it the progress achieved by a teacher in teaching students? Which one do you think is the most suitable? Let me give you 2 seconds to think it over. Do you think it can be the reading the latest teaching magazines? Do you think this is going to achieve enough professional development? What about assessment and evaluation? Does assessment or evaluation, is it considered a kind of professional development for the teacher? So the answer is, it's the acquisition of skills and knowledge. That's the most important thing about professional development. It doesn't only improve our knowledge, but it also adds to our skills. It improves our skills. So the next question, which comes, essential question, which comes after this question, what is professional development? Why is it necessary for us? Why is it necessary for any professional? Why is professional development that important? Well, yes, it's both for personal and development and for career advancement. We have to develop ourselves and our skills, and at the same time we always look for better jobs, better promotions. So in order to achieve get better promotions, we should develop our skills and extend our experience so that we would be able to help others and perfect our work. At the same time, professional development is very important also because it improves your skills, increase your value to your organization. For sure, when we have a highly organized person, a highly developed, a skillfully developed person, and he has good experience, and at the same time he's a talented employee or a talented teacher, for sure this would increase your value to your organization and enhance your future career prospects. It would offer you the chance to get better jobs in better places. Let's ask ourselves also another question. Do all schools offer the right kind of professional development for teachers? If you take a look at this article from We Are Teachers website, you will find that we have here ins and outs about professional development. When teachers get guided, through professional development learning networks, they join different learning networks. They mix with in-person sessions, classroom observations. Means they get involved in classroom observations. They have hands-on experience in different workshops. They view core skills as the responsibility of educators. Viewing core skills, no matter the subjects they teach, they view different subjects for different teachers. For sure, they are going to gain different skills from these different teachers. It's a different kind of experience that observing other peers would add a lot to your skills as a teacher and your talent as a teacher. How you, for sure, you are going to find something good or something that you don't like about the other teachers. So how do you see it, and then how is this going to help you to see yourself better as a teacher and how to develop yourself? Also, at the same time, there are some flexible courses that give teachers open-ended strategies for meeting the standards. They help, but also allow a lot of originality lots of flexible courses. They ask teachers to apply what they learn in classes, and they are observed to see what are the advantages and disadvantages of this and how they can apply it in their own schools, in their own classes. All this is in contrast with the other column, professional development topics chosen by the principal on behalf of the entire faculty. Of course, this does not personalize the professional development and does not give the teachers the chance to choose what they really like to develop. Sometimes the school sees something and the teacher sees something else, and they don't get along together, and so the teacher doesn't benefit enough from the training, and at the same time the students are not going to benefit as well. A handful of in-person professional development sessions over the course of a year, often covering unrelated topics. This is one of the most irritating problems for teachers in schools. Sometimes they are forced to attend these different kinds of sessions, and they are not related at all to what they do, or they are not practical enough, or they know it already, so they benefit nothing. It's just a waste of time. Professional development delivered lecture style, just you give a lecture and it's not interactive. You send English teachers to reading and writing workshops, and math teachers to multiplication ones. In other words, they are highly unpractical sessions, and so the teachers gain nothing. They get bored and they can even play truant as students do in school, and they don't benefit anything. And when will we have time for these sessions that ignore state benchmarks and creative stripping trainings that focus on nothing but bubble tests? Unfortunately, some training sessions, they just train the teachers how to become to train their students better to get better marks. That's it. And so, in which case, the students, the teachers do not benefit from this, as it's a status quo. The teachers remain the same, and they gain nothing in the end. So, if we put the pros and cons together of professional development, it's one of the most important things is that we should personalize professional development so that the teachers would be eager enough in order to do professional development, and at the same time think how to do it in the best possible way. Let's move ahead with the next section. Let's ask ourselves, how can we pursue professional development if we say that we as individuals, not as schools, we want to have professional development? How can we do it? How do you think? What are the different kinds of ways that teachers can follow in order to gain professional development? Let me suggest a few ways. First of all, case study methods are very effective. If you it's a personal experience. I myself used to read lots of case studies from different countries, applying different methods of teaching or teaching projects in different countries in the world, and what were the results in the end, and what's the reflections about these results. For sure, it helps teachers to gain lots of information, lots of experience through reading these study cases and analyzing them. Another point also is consultation. You can ask your supervisor and older colleague, people whom you trust and you believe that they have enough experience that can help you to tell you what ways to track in order to be able to achieve professional development. Also, one of the interesting ways is coaching. This coaching has been followed in the last few years in a number of schools around the world, where an older teacher mentors another younger teacher, and sometimes they work together. The younger teacher works beside the older teacher in order to observe what he or she is doing and gain more experience from this. Also, we have communities of practice, groups of teachers. They practice, they read, for example, different articles together. They explain different kinds of lessons in front of each other, so the group of teachers is going to comment on the pros and cons of the lessons explained, and so the teachers gain in depth into their own teaching. Lesson study also to analyze different lessons from videos, let's say on YouTube or taped videos in different places. Lesson study is very important. The analysis of these lessons are very, very important. The teacher, in this case, we turn the teacher into a teacher researcher. The teacher studies the lesson, what's the objective of the lesson, what are the steps followed, what are the activities followed, what are the games played by the teacher in class in order to make the lesson fun. What about the homework? What about writing in class? What about the revision? Different kinds of steps that can be analyzed through different lessons. Mentoring, which is one of the most beautiful ways of professional development, when you have a much, much older teacher and you consider that this teacher is your senior guardian, and this teacher is going to help you to make a professional development plan for yourself, is going to follow you up and tell you are doing this right, this is wrong, what do you think of this, what do you think of that, and you go back to the teacher, this senior teacher, every now and then. It helps a lot with lots of teachers like this very much. This can be done in different ways, not necessarily to have the same senior teacher in the same school. You can have it in a different school, a person whom you trust, let's say a role model for teaching for you. Another one is reflective supervision. Also, you can ask your peers to come to your class, watch your classes, and give you their observation about what you do in class. Technical assistance, of course, you can get this through your supervisor or head of the department. These are wonderful, some of the wonderful ways that you can use for personal professional development. Let me ask you about another question. Do you think that professional development should be done on individual or group basis, and why? Individual basis is important. You have to start, you have to have the initiative, but at the same time, if you can do it with a group, this is more motivating and it gives you much better ideas than just to have your own idea alone. So professional development in a group is much more effective, but again, the individual one is very important. Let us, this makes us wonder, this idea of having professional development is very important for us, maybe because we have read a lot, we have got in contact with the internet a lot, because we live in urban areas. But what about the people who live in poor areas, in the urban areas, also in poor parts of the cities, or people who have no facilities at all? What about teachers who have no facilities, no supervision, or live in rural areas? What can we do about these people? As I have just told you, those people need people to help. Sometimes we find people from these different places telling us, please come, we have no facilities, we have nothing, want somebody to help us, just give us ideas, track us the way, tell us what to do, because the city is very far from us and is very ghosty and we don't know what to do. So here in Egypt, since I've been in the teaching profession for lots of years, over 30 years in fact, we have thought of an idea that can help people in different places, or even people who live in good places, what to do. Lots of people seek professional development, but they don't know how to do it. It's not easy for them to have a mentor or even a coach. So we came up with a new idea. Why not form an online network among Egyptian English language teachers? That's why we thought we can do it first online. And we started with the Egyptian teachers, since we know that lots of Egyptians really are in need of this idea of professional development. So we came up with this idea of we started thinking of this idea because we believe it's a community responsibility. It's not an individual responsibility. We should share together, collaborate together in trying to solve this idea. Why not ask people from teachers from different places to join us in order to help in this kind of development? So we came up with this idea of our community. we started thinking, why don't we get down to the teachers in schools, whether private or governmental, and call them for professional development and help them sustain a lifelong one? The idea itself to go to these places, to these schools, and call the people for professional development, when we started, was a big challenge, because lots of people say we don't have time during the school year, and even the summer vacation we have to take the kids to the summer resorts, or we have to stay home, we have to take a rest. So it was a great challenge for us, not to call people and convince them of the importance of professional development, but also to sustain it as a lifelong one. We believe that professional development should start with the teacher. Should start with the teacher himself or herself. It has to be personalized. It has to come to be. You have to be convinced as a teacher of the importance of professional development. It has to be blended. Means I have to use different ways. As we said before, we have coaching, we have mentoring, we have lesson study, case study, different things, courses, workshops to attend. It has to be blended to get as much benefit as possible. Collaborative, why not share together as a group of teachers or at school in doing this kind of professional development? It has to be supportive. Somebody has to support you, whether the school, the administration, the head of department, your friends, your colleagues. You have to be supported by someone to help you, give you motivation to go ahead. And to be ongoing, be motivated all the time, motivate yourself all the time to that you have to go on with professional development and never to give up whatever happens. And sometimes people or teachers, when they study something, they would like to apply it, but sometimes it's a failure and they get nowhere. So they believe there is no need for professional development. I forget about it. I won't apply anything. But you have to keep on trying and trying and think of different ways. Let's think of the whole story as if we have a child who is a slow learner or a child who has learning difficulties. Are you going to leave him or are you going to check for different ways to help him? So that's the idea. We have to track different ways for professional development to help not only ourselves but our students, who are the final goal of this kind of professional development. This nice idea was set through intel.com edu next thing. How did we start? How did it start our community? We started of having this kind of a training community. We started first with courses and workshops. And then when we started attracting people's attention through the internet and through these courses and workshops, we started having a number of programs that would help teachers be convinced of the importance of professional development. We started convincing people to come to weekly discussions. The teachers come from different schools to attend discussions about any topics concerning teaching for 2 hours. We do it once a week. On the last day of the school, last school day of the week, which is Thursday for us here. And then we started inviting teachers to come to internship programs. The teachers would spend with us 3 months. We would help them get their professional level evaluated, help them have a plan for professional development, attend professional development sessions for 2 weeks, every 2 weeks, attend all weekly discussions, and we have also the teaching club, which I'm going to speak about after that. And then they would get their professional development level after 3 months evaluated, and they get a certificate for that. This was one of the programs that attracted a number of teachers. We had 2 groups of teachers, and they joined in these 2 internships. And the best thing about these internships is that the teachers start reflecting this on what they do in classes, and they start thinking of the problems that they have, and they were looking for answers for them, but with no success. Another thing that we do also is that the teaching club, we have this event at on the last Saturday of every month, and we invite 3 distinguished speakers from different places, and we have people face to face, or we have people, distinguished people online. Like for example, we had Dr. Vivian Cook, we had Vicky Hollett, we had Scott Thornbury, and we had Adrian Underhill as well. The teachers enjoyed speaking to those people online And that was so exciting.
In addition to the teaching club, we also have this networking scheme. We are in touch with lots of people around the world, and not only in Egypt but around the world as well, through our network of Maha ESL training community. We set different posts online that help teachers with professional development, and at the same time help in communication with teachers with different experiences around the world. And this is our Facebook page and group, if you'd like to join us. Here we have a number of pictures of some of the events that we have already arranged. So far we have arranged 8 teaching clubs and lots of weekly discussions. And at the same time, we are having our internship program. We are trying to get to as many teachers in as many schools as possible in order to be able to spread the belief in long life professional development. Thank you. Hope you enjoy the photos.